school and the performance, the spectacular performance by the students, sir?
You've used the right word, spectacular. Spectacular is what it was. I have been going to school functions for 25 years, 30 years. And you know schools that have been running for 25, 30, 40 years, etc. I have seldom seen the level of energy and the beauty, the enthusiasm and the participation of the whole school. It was an incredible, incredible experience, and I am absolutely delighted. And I believe that the younger they were, the more confident they were, and this is this gives great confidence about the generations to come in our country. And if we can look after these kids well, these children well, I think we would have done a great national service.
So earlier you were, sir, External Affairs Minister. So what do you think, sir, in current scenario, India is standing internationally?
See, there are two things. India's standing is of a more permanent nature, because it's the personality of India, the place of India, the size of India, the economy of India. But what at any given time are the relations of the government of India with other countries? I'm sorry, I can't say very much there, because our relations with our neighboring countries, we saw a beautiful performance of Sark here, but our relations with our neighboring countries, including China, are not something that we can be very excited about. We were hoping to get something out of America. We've just got empty words. We had a remarkable relationship with the Soviet Union in the past, the Russian Federation as a successor state. We don't have that special relationship that we had. So I can't say that this government's performance on the international front has been very satisfactory or very good.
Sir, any comments on the current exit polls coming of recent assembly elections?
Well, I can't complain. Our exit polls are showing that 11th of December, the national discourse will change, that we will certainly do very well in the major states of India, which is Rajasthan and Madhya Pradesh. And BJP will not have a lot to say elsewhere, whether it's Mizoram or Telangana. So I think that we will be on a we'll have an edge over the BJP in the results of this election, and that will mean that the entire discourse in the country will change. This business of saying that we'll have Congress Mukt Bharat, etc., will be thrown into the dustbin.
Sir, one last question, sir. Once again, sir, Ram Mandir issue is heated up. So, sir, any comment on that? That many of the social organizations were demanding amendments. So, what's your take on that, sir?
Why does the Ram Mandir issue become relevant? Why doesn't Bhagwan Ram remain relevant? Bhagwan Ram is permanent, perennial. He's always there. Anyone who chooses only a particular time to speak about the temple, but no time at all for Bhagwan Ram himself, you can judge what their true intentions may be. You can't reduce God or Bhagwan to being a manifesto element in an election. Bhagwan is much larger, and Bhagwan doesn't belong to any one individual or one party. I think that people are very sensible, and they know what the place of Bhagwan Ram is. And how high that place is and how important that place is, they're not going to allow that to be reduced in importance and reduced to the level of humans fighting over it.
Thank you so much for talking with me.